एवरीवन, दिस इज रामलिंग प्रसाद कुप्पा। वेलकम टू माय चैनल फार्मा वर्ल्ड। टुडेज टॉपिक इज आर्काइवल ऑफ फार्मास्यूटिकल मैन्युफैक्चरिंग डॉक्यूमेंट्स। लेट अस सी द रिक्वायरमेंट। सेक्शन 6.12 ऑफ ICHQ 7 प्रिस्क्राइब्स ए प्रोसीजर शुड बी एस्टैब्लिश्ड फॉर retaining all appropriate documents, example development history reports, scale up reports, technical transfer reports, process validation reports, training records, production records, control records and distribution records. This section prescribes on the requirements of archival of pharmaceutical manufacturing documents. A detailed procedure should be in place with the details of appropriate documents, development history reports, scale-up reports, technical transfer reports, process validation reports, training records, production records, control records and distribution records are some important examples. The manufacturer should decide on appropriateness for more such documents if required. Let us see how long these have to be archived. Development history reports, scale-up reports or technical reports are not considered as routine documents. They give the entire calendar of events of the technical details of the process. So they have to be archived for longer periods, maybe as long as the product is being listed in the product list. They have to be stored till the end of the product life cycle. Process validation reports are also important negotiable documents with customers, including the regulatory agencies, because the data from these initial validation lots will be used for regulatory filings. These documents may have to be retained longer, as any time the customer may request the data to respond to any regulatory query on using these batches in their filing. Other routine manufacturing records, including training records, production records, control records, and distribution records, can be archived for shorter time as prescribed in the section 6.13. The retention periods for these documents should be specified. It is necessary to list out clearly the various types of all the available documents related to the product, specifying the retention period for each type. Section 6.13 prescribes all production, control, distribution records should be retained for at least 1 year after the expiry date of the batch. For APIs with retest dates, records should be retained for at least 3 years after the batch is completely distributed. There are two conditions. One is at least 1 year after the expiry date of the batch. It is calculated based on the assumption that all the product by then would have been consumed and there were no adverse impact reports pending. This is valid for products that have expiry date. For products with a retest date, it is 3 years after complete distribution of the batch. See, there is a link between the retention period and the distribution of the batch. Obviously, there should be a monitoring mechanism to link these two. Section 6.15 prescribes during the retention period, originals or copies of the records should be readily available at the establishment where the activities described in such records occurred. Records that can promptly be retrieved from another location by electronic or other means are acceptable. Section 6.15 prescribes that all the relevant records for which such activities had been carried out should be available readily. That means such records should be easily accessible for any reference. There is another provision. Certain activities that are carried out at a common location, the data may be retrieved electronically or by any other quicker means. Testing for particle size distribution by laser equipment or microbiology testing, etc., at one specific site or at contract laboratory are some of the examples. Section 6.16 prescribes specifications, instructions, procedures, and records can be retained either as originals or as true copies, such as photocopies, microfilm, microfiche, and other accurate reproductions of the original records. Section 6.16 prescribes that the listed documents can be retained as originals or true copies. True copy is a photocopy of the original or a transcribed document with a verification signature as a true copy. A stamp as true copy may be affixed at the bottom of such documents. For accurate reproduction, the listed systems such as photocopies, microfilm, microfiche, or other accurate reproductions may be used. Let us see other important references. GMP documents, records as prescribed under 21 CFR Part 211, 67C, 68A, 68B, 72, 80D, 122C, 130E, 166, 182, 184, 186, 188, 192, 194, 196, 198, 204, etc. have to be retained as per 21 CFR 211.180. Various sections of 21 CFR Part 211, including this list, have to be retained at least 1 year after the expiry of the product or 3 years after the complete distribution of the batch. The sections referred here refers to various conditions for recording during the pharmaceutical manufacturing activity. Schedule M of the Drugs and Cosmetics Act 1940 prescribes that all GMP and GLP records as generated as per sections 12 till 29 have to be maintained for at least 1 year after the expiry of the finished product, that is the drug product. Schedule M of the Drugs and Cosmetics Act 1940 and Rules 1945 prescribes under section 12.4 that records and associated standard operating procedures shall be retained for at least 1 year after the expiry date of the finished product. Udralex Volume 4, Part 1, Section 4.11 and Section 4.12 of Chapter 4 also prescribes the archival requirements of the document. These sections in Udralex Volume 4, Part 1, Chapter 4 also suggest such requirement. Section 4.12 prescribes that for other types of documentation, the retention period will depend on the business activity which the document supports. Critical documentation including raw data, for example, related to validation or stability, which supports the information in the marketing authorization, should be retained as long as the marketing authorization is active. It may be considered acceptable to obsolete documents like raw data or supporting validation reports or stability reports where the data has been superseded by another full set of new data. Justification for this should be documented and should be supported by full set of comprehensive data from validation batches exercise. Let us see the strategy on retention of the documentation. Development history reports, scale-up reports, technical transfer reports are very important documents that may have to be retained for the lifetime of the product. These listed documents are the source documents for the product from the start to the commercialization step. These are not really routine documents. It is recommended that these documents may be converted into electronic format for retaining quite longer periods. The length of the time should be up to the end of the product life cycle. Data from routine manufacturing records may be extracted into a statistical evaluated format and retained longer as microfilm format. Even the data from routine documents may be extracted into electronic format. It is really very difficult to manage the huge number of hard copies for storage. This needs huge safe storage space also. So hard copies have to be salvaged under control. This should be treated as authorized activity. There should be a detailed system on destruction of documents after the retention period. You should list out all the documents of the manufacturing in detail. Assign retention period for each document with a well-defined justification. Step-by-step procedure for identifying the obsolete documents, collecting, reconciling, and bundling them up for destruction. Details of shredding the documents or any other suitable method and evidence of the destruction should be a part of the procedure. Update the destruction register. The destruction register should have the details of number of documents destroyed, who did the destruction, who witnessed the destruction also. I hope that the concept of archival and destruction of manufacturing documents after the retention period is understood well. Review your procedure and check whether or not these aspects are incorporated in the SOP. Thanks for watching. For more videos, please do subscribe, like, and share. Thank you.